Hi everyone, this is Sharmila and welcome back to my channel Sharmila's Kitchen. Today I am back with new recipe. As all the festivals and celebrations are so close to us, it's the right time to make something sweet. Today I'll be making one of the popular and delicious sweets of India, that is Bundi Laddu. Bundi Laddus are made with perfectly round shaped bundis or droplets soaked in sugar syrup and then make into small balls. The secret of perfect round shaped bundis lies in batter consistency and also sugar syrup. So let's get into the cooking. Before that, take a look to the ingredient list. First, in a mixing bowl, add besan or gram flour. To make laddus, we need thicker variety of besan, but the besan that we get from local shop is thinner variety most of the times. So that's why I'm adding 1 tablespoon of suji or rava to give the besan thickness. Also add pinch of kesar color or saffron color. Adding color is totally optional. As we are making halwa style bundi laddu, so I added. Just a quick mix to combine all together. Now I'll be adding little water at a time and make a thick batter. Make sure you add little water at a time to get the required consistency. If you add all the water together, the batter will get so many lumps and it will be hard to break them. Adding little water at a time also ensures that your batter is in right consistency. Now as you can see, the batter that I made is very thick. Now we will keep it aside for 30 minutes. In this 30 minutes, the besan will absorb more water and become thick. After that, we will add more water to make it in right consistency. While the batter is resting, let me show you the perforated spoon or jhara that we are going to be using today. In the shop or market, you'll be getting different varieties of perforated ladle or jhara like this. Over the years, I have bought so many perforated ladles to make different types of bundi laddu or motichur laddu. To make bundi laddu, this kind of perforated ladle is ideal because it has perfect round shape holes in which the batter can hold the shape of bundi and drip off easily. And this is another kind of perforated ladle which is good for making motichur laddu. I also have motichur laddu recipe on my channel. If you want to learn, then you can also watch that recipe. So after 30 minutes, the batter has rested very well and it has become thick. So to bring the batter in right consistency, we will add little more water, about 2 tablespoon water. After adding water, mix the batter again. Then it will come in right consistency. Here is a small and easy trick for you. Just dip in your index finger in the batter. The batter will coat your index finger. Also, it will drip off very easily. And the batter flow will be like dropping consistency. That means the batter is in right consistency and ready to make bundis. Now in a karai, heat 2 cups of oil. You can also make it in desi ghee. Now when the oil is very hot, pour a ladle full batter to the perforated ladle and also make sure the ladle is on the top of the oil. After pouring the batter in the perforated ladle, the bundis will fall down into the oil easily. And you also don't need to rub the batter to fall. Just keep the ladle on the top of the oil and it will easily fall. See how nicely the bundis are getting done and they are all very perfectly round shaped. As you can see, dear friends, just stir it for a few seconds and at this stage, keep the flame medium to low so that the bundis don't be over fried. So keeping the flame low, I am taking out the bundis using a tea sieve. You can also use another perforated ladle to take out the bundis, but I found this tea sieve is great. Remove the bundis using tea sieve without wasting the oil. Also make sure the oil is clear enough. There should not be any bundis left in the oil. So when we put the bundis for second batch, the previous bundis will be dark. So when we will put the bundis for second batch. Also make sure the perforated ladle is also clean enough. There should not be any batter in the holes, then it will be difficult for bundis to fall from the holes. Repeat the same process to make other bundis. When the batter is almost fell down, you can shake it little bit to drip off rest of the batter. So when the bundis are formed nicely, give it a gentle stir using the perforated spoon and then take out the bundis. So this way I have made all the bundis and set it aside. Now we have little more batter left. So using this batter, we will be making color bundis. So divide the batter in two bowls. Here I will be making green bundi and red bundi. So in this batter, I am going to be adding green color. Adding color is purely optional, as I am making halwa style bundi laddu, that's why I am adding little bit of color. In another bowl of batter, I am going to be adding little bit of red food color and mix it nicely. Make sure there are no streaks of color left in the batter. Now similarly, make red color bundis and also green color bundis. The color in the bundis making it very gorgeous. Take it out and mix it with other bundis. In the hot oil, I am adding some chopped cashew nuts. Fry it for few seconds. So when the cashews are slightly golden brown, add raisins and immediately take out the cashew nuts and raisins. Now let's make sugar syrup. In another karai or pan, add about 1.5 cup of sugar and 1/2 cup of water. Give a gentle mix and let the sugar dissolve. To make the bundi laddu flavorful, add 2 crushed cardamom pods. Now cook the sugar syrup for 4 to 5 minutes. When you see the sugar syrup is bubbling, when you see the sugar syrup is creating big bubbles like this, that means it is done. Or you can check the sugar syrup is done or not. In this way, take little bit of water in a bowl and add the sugar syrup. If the sugar syrup is not dissolving with the water, that means it is done. So the sugar syrup is ready now. Switch off the flame. After switching off the flame, you should add the bundis. So here I am adding the bundis and I also added fried cashews and raisins. Now mix the bundi in the sugar syrup. The bundis will absorb the sugar syrup and will become dry. So keep mixing for 2 to 3 minutes. So after mixing, you can see the sugar syrup is already dissolved and here is no sugar syrup left in the karai. So when it is in this stage, take out the bundis immediately from the karai and transfer in a plate. Before making the laddu, dip your palm in the water and take a big portion of the bundis in your palm. Press it gently to make round balls. When we will make the balls, some of the bundis will fall down. That is completely fine. See how easily the bundi laddus are getting rolled. So just take a handful of sweet bundis in your palm and press it very tightly and the laddus will form. So this way I'll be making all the laddu. See, in front of you I have made all the bundi laddu. Don't say that I have brought it from the shop. So if I can make this bundi laddu, you can also make this awesome and lovely bundi laddu at home. Now I will serve this bundi laddu. It is a great sweet to celebrate any occasions or festivals. It will taste good after 3 to 4 hours of making, because after 3 to 4 hours the flavor will be more strong and the sweetness will mature. After making this bundi laddu, you can store it up to 6 to 7 days. First 2 days you can store in the room temperature. After 2 days, store in the refrigerator. So my bundi laddus are done. I hope you guys enjoyed watching this video. If you like this recipe, Please hit the like button, share with your family and friends, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel.